Oh, hello, fellow vehicle sim fans. Welcome back to Korivak Vehicle Sims. I'm Marcus Korivak. Today, part 2 of Off-Road October. Alright, so the first thing we're going to do today is fix this mess. So I have a theory that this truck really wants to be rubber side down and just needs an ever so slight tug that direction in order to get back upright again. We're going to test that theory by switching over to our little Jeep here and driving over there and giving it that little tiny glove tap. While we're over there, we can also get the two tanks on top of our trunk filled up with their liters of fuel, because right now they're empty. Lights because it's getting to nighttime. 2,000 hours. Oh, this little guy does not do as well in the mud, but it's light enough to go driving along the edge of the mud. Stay out of the forest with the stickiness. Take a quick look here. We definitely want to go straight across. It's a little bit shallower over here, though. So these little red bars indicate how deep the water is. There's a lot going on over there. Let's do it. I'm coming up on something. What's these rocks here? Try and enter the stream a little bit upstream, so as we wash down river. Alright. This darker stuff right here in the middle, that indicates how wet it is, so that's going to be a really muddy little trench through there. We're going to mostly stay on the road, I think. So we can go off this way. Tire tracks off to nowhere. Instead of going into the wet stuff, we're going to slip off this direction instead. Watch out for this log over here. I 1 again. They're breaking these trees, maybe right there. Drop a marker on there and there. It's a little bit wet down there, I suspect. This should be the best break in the trees. Try to go up this relatively straight and not roll again. Oh. This little tiny Jeep is about the only vehicle that can sneak through stuff like this. Anything larger is going to get hung up on those trees, something fierce. And we're here. In here, try not to hit any of these rocks too hard. Oh goodness, very rocky. Yeah, it's definitely rocky in here. This might be cheatingest winch job ever, where I'm using the truck I'm here to pull back upright as a winch point. But if it works, it works. Gear shift. This is not going so well. Let's come on, camera. Damn it, camera. Well, that's apparently enough to get it to start up. Oh no, no, no. Alright, switch to pull. Parking brake on. Brakes on. Nope. Nice. Attach winch. Winch source. Winch destiny. There we go. Parking brake. Actual brake. This is not working out. Nope. Definitely stuck in there more than I can pull out with this little tiny thing. Did not just need a nudge, needs a bit more. I have an idea, but it's definitely not a very good one. No. Not even budging. Definitely nothing to winch on. I can't get on the other side to give this thing a hit from that side. Just digging myself in. All right. Well, at least we can still do part B of this crazy plan. This thing does not have quite the axle for this. Just not enough ground clearance. There we go. I'm hung up. Turn for fuel. Yes. Let's get up to speed before we try and stay from here. See this thing bouncing around, it gets noticeably top heavy with the trunk up there. Short little wheelbase, a lot of weight carried up high. It's not the most solid and stable of vehicles. Oh no! I'm stopped. Alright, it's got our 80 liters in the internal tank, 80 liters up here on the roof. And for the time being, I'm just going to park this thing off to the side. Parking brake. Stop engine, because otherwise it's going to just be burning fuel for the whole time. Alright. So, let's do the 4320 that's already here. Somewhat damaged, but it does have a spare wheel. That's better. Leave the trailer here. So this guy is a good and proper heavy off-road vehicle. An actual truck instead of just a Jeep or a light truck that's an overgrown Jeep. This one is going to actually be able to dig through whatever this road throws at us and pull out our V66 with no problem. But a lot heavier and with a worse turning radius. So let's try not to drive like a lunatic. On our all-wheel drive for just a split second there, and our fuel usage shot up to 20 liters per minute. You can see how this truck can very easily run low on fuel or out of fuel. This might be a little steep. Nope, it's fine. It's all fine. Switch to pull, parking brake on, brakes on, and that was easy. That was very easy. Alright, so release. Is it easier to drive out this way or back out the way I came? Definitely back out the way I came. This gets really, really wet over here. Look how dark that is. Let's not go that way. All right. Gear down a bit, turn off our parking brake. Not to slam into the truck we just rescued. bit and just dig ourselves deeper and deeper in for forever. How much trouble we were having with our UAZ getting hung up on these rocks. Yeah, that's not a thing anymore. Torn up in here now because I've been mucking about back and forth. It is not having any of this, is it? And there we go. all that work to go from right there down to there and then up to here. So, mission accomplished. That's kind of the nature of Spintires. A lot of work, sometimes not a lot of ground covered. That's why these things are all measured in liters of fuel per minute, not per unit of distance. Alright, so we'll just cut it here for now, and then now that we're back Riverside down, we'll see where we can get ourselves into next.